Hello, everyone. Hope you're having a great day. And trust me, it's going to be more exciting as we have three updates for you today, amongst which two are related to starships. So, let's start. Not too long after the previous Starship, SN8, completed its high-altitude flight test, another prototype is getting ready to make its way for testing. SpaceX is now looking to put its current Starship, SN9, on the launch pad. As per that, there is a thin possibility that SN9 will be ready for launch by the end of this year. For the upcoming year, SpaceX might be planning more launches than this year. SN9's test campaign could be the way to kick off 2021. According to sources, SpaceX will include a production of a total of 9 Starship prototypes in various stages, along with its first Super Heavy prototype. SpaceX's previous Starship prototype, SN8, went beyond expectations with its first high-altitude launch, although the prototype exploded during the landing. The CEO of SpaceX, Elon Musk, went to the crash site to observe the situation. According to Musk, SN8's nose cone will be preserved as a sign of its achievement. On the other hand, a week ago, SN9 tipped around 5 degrees and hit the bay sidewall, which caused a temporary damage to the aero surfaces of its nose cone. Tankzilla, a giant crawler crane, went to rescue SN9. SpaceX took some days for the recovery work and also used a new aero surface for SN9. SpaceX is planning to conduct a 12.5-kilometer flight before it will move on to the next stage, where the company will conduct a flight test of 15 to 20 kilometers with its future Starship. For future Starship programs, SN11 is currently stacked in the mid-bay with SN10. SN12 will also join the line in the near future. A local photographer also spotted a section which belongs to SN17. It signifies that SpaceX is planning for a wide range of testing with several Starship prototypes until it achieves a satisfying result. The year 2020 is ending. With full of new ambitions for the upcoming year, SpaceX began making some progress on its new Starship prototype, SN10. According to sources from SpaceX's South Texas rocket factory, the company has begun adding final touches to SN10's nose cone. On December 19th, Saturday, SpaceX began the final stacking work for its next Starship, SN10's nose section, made of a conical nose cone on the top of several steel rings. SpaceX's SN10 is next in the Starship prototype lineup after SN9's, which is its launch pad. Now, there's a slight structural difference in the nose section of SN10. Unlike SN8 and SN9's nose section, SpaceX planned to make SN10's nose section assembly one ring shorter, from 5 to 4, which means they would subtract nose rings instead of adding it to the top of the rocket's tank section, although the reason for this change is still unknown. SN10's nose cone first spotted by Mary, also known as Boca Chica Gale. At SpaceX, Boca Chica Starship SN10 nose cone is being stacked into the windbreak. Moreover, it all depends on whether the work is done or not. If the work is not already complete, then SpaceX's integration team will join the nose and its rings with one or two circumferential welds, which will cover the whole 28-meter, approximately 90 feet, circumference. Meanwhile, SN10's avionics wiring, hydraulic tubing, and liquid oxygen feed lines needed to operate the nose's cold gas thrusters, flaps, and propellant header tank. These will be connected from all the way through the nose ring section. After its completion, the nose section will be stacked on top of its airframe. If SpaceX allows the same criteria like SN9, then the final installation of SN10's nose cone will be done by the end of December. The nose section installation of SN10 will be nearly identical to its predecessor. As the current Starship, SN9, moved to its launch pad, SpaceX will be focused on completing its next Starship model, SN10. SN10's tank and engine section will be transferred to the high bay for nose section installation. SpaceX is keeping its fast and steady pace in their Starship program, which is going on by testing several prototypes. A Starship, after its completion, could bring revolutionary changes to the global space industry, but it would take some years for that to happen. As for now, SpaceX's SN9 is a few days away before making its way from the launch pad. SpaceX will be looking to achieve more milestones in SN9's testing. If somehow SN9 fails during testing or its high-altitude launch attempt, then Starship SN10 will carry out the next round of testing. Now we'll move on to the next segment of our news. Let's take a look on the news of changed space industries. With the present action of SpaceX, along with China, Russia, Japan, India, and missions of a few other countries, the world purview of space industry has changed. Especially Elon Musk's SpaceX has been performing a revolutionary role for the last one decade of space exploration industry. The commercial market of space application relies totally upon the customers. Their demand is high-quality services and good performance. The space companies should be capable of giving high-quality performance in order to bring in customers. With the entrance of small satellites in the space market, new ways of business have been flung open. These small satellites can be used for maintenance, refueling, and observation of these satellites operational in orbit around Earth. With the coming of small satellites, another industry has grown up with it: space insurance industry. Within the next decade, constellations of small satellites would transform the global space industry. These small satellites will decrease the cost of the space infrastructure, as the small size of these satellites will drastically reduce the cost of conveyance to space, and in turn, it can be mass-produced. It's generally seen that the space industry is headed by public organization. Especially, we can take NASA as an example of such type of public organization. Industry now more depends on both public and private infrastructure. This alteration in the industry is taking place in a governmental framework subjugated by permanent crisis in international governance of space activities. The United States is proceeding as a leader in space industry with the Artemis agreements. Till 9 states have already signed the agreement. It would likely increase if the European Union joins and suggests an alternative to Artemis program. The Digital Services Act and the Digital Market Act are two recent regulations. The Space Market Act has to be supported in accordance with these two regulations. The launch of groups of small satellites will increase the amount of data regarding Earth and space. Once this data is processed, it would be like a ready-made material for many industries. This data will help in offering several commercial services. This collection of spatially derived data could be troublesome. Some governments will look for safeguarding their satellites by locating safety zones. With the increase of private companies in the space industry, flow of financial transactions will be continued. These financial transactions would include acquisitions, fundraising in the different series, calls to the financial markets with or without special purpose acquisition company. The modern space industry can no more stay as an intruder to the incidents happening in present days. There is a constant change towards more information and data, which is literally found in the information and communications technology industry. Coalition between the space and IT industries can be easily found. With the coming of the GPS and small satellite technology, the move to electric vehicles will bring with it a big challenge, i.e. being able to guide vehicles during automatic driving. Software alliance for e-mobility. Charge Up Europe will certainly be necessary between space and terrestrial, modern and more well-built industries, as they've begun to be under GNSS, European Safety Critical Applications Positioning Engine Program. Now the competition that awaits all operators of terrestrial or satellite infrastructures should be that of Internet of Things. Development of the terrestrial infrastructure, 5G, is a complement added by the revolutionary small satellites. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.